beginner showmanship class, grades 3 and 4. So if you are in the first year showmanship class, grades 5 and up, you should be making your way to the Farm Progress Arena at this time. So once again, if you are in the second showmanship class, which is first year showman, grades 5 and up, you should be making your way to the Farm Progress Arena and checking in, please.
Yeah.
eye on me and an eye on our calves. They work really well together as a pair. The calf is well trained. And the young lady does a good job of noticing her calf's pulse, keeping a little extra throat. She always had that throat hold and was very smooth at getting her heifer set up when I did stop them in line. And she uses her advantage and overall kind of smoothness and the way she exhibits her calf to place over the young man in second. Again, the young man in second has a very well groomed calf. He does a really good job of, again, his calf broaches a little bit. And so he did a good job of knowing that and pitching her down when she was set up. Again, they both did a good job of getting the feet set up as soon as I had them positioned. And they use those advantages to place over the young girl in third. Again, in third place, a beautifully fit calf. Just didn't get the calf set up quite as quickly and have the correct feet positioning as those ahead of her. She used her advantage, though, in ability to the way the calf is trained to place over our calf in fourth. Fourth over fifth, again, just the ability to lead her calf a little bit smoothly. Unfortunately, our young girl in fifth, her calf is acting up a little bit today, but she stayed. But she stayed in good spirits and worked well with a very difficult calf in the class. And so we commend all these exhibitors for sticking out and doing a good job in this damp weather. So congratulations to all exhibitors.
Congratulations to the winner of our beginner showmanship class, grades 3 and 4, Marissa Spoke. Marissa received a blue ribbon. She received a trophy sponsored by Cheryl Nails, a show halter donated by East Central Select Sire, and a sweatshirt by Confier Financial. At this time, entering the ring, we have our first-year showman grades 5 and up. First-year showman grades 5 and up. The results of the other students, or other members in that first class, placing second and earning a blue ribbon was Trent Schlender. Placing third and earning a blue ribbon was Madison Goodex. Placing fourth and getting a blue ribbon was Lily Gira. Placing fifth with a red ribbon, Mary Swald. Placing sixth with a red ribbon was Kimberly Callies. And placing seventh with a red ribbon was Emilia Muska. Mm-hmm. showman class for grades 5 and up is a fairly small class. So if you are in our junior showmanship class, which is grades 5 and 6, you should be making your way to the Farm Progress Arena, getting checked in at this time.
Thank you.
fight against her and was able to kind of bring her in and get her set up in an appropriate way. Again, she was able to hold the head in the proper position, she pulled throat, and she also, again, like I said, got the heifer set up most correctly the most times when I was watching. The young man, second again, works really well with his heifer. A few times I caught him not being set up quite right. Also need to work on getting that tail head pinched down when we're in line, but otherwise he did a really nice job with his calf. Also talked to these exhibitors in class about halter fit. I want to remember to try to get the halter snug up on the bridge of the nose a little bit further, so something to keep in mind for those other exhibitors coming in today. And our young lady in third, again, did a really nice job with her calf. They worked together as a pair. You can tell they she spent time training her. We just recommend she works on keeping her eye on the judge as well as on her calf. But congratulations to all you first-year exhibitors.
Congratulations to the winner of our first-year showman grade. 5 and up. Our winner was Tara Schultz, placing first, earning a blue ribbon. She also received a trophy sponsored by Partnership Bank of Watertown. East Central Select Sires donated a show halter, and Compeer Financial donated their champion showmanship sweatshirt. Placing second in the class and earning a blue ribbon was Connor Roach. Earning third place and a blue ribbon also was Giselle Avila. Entering the ring at this time, we have our junior showmanship. Junior showmanship is grades 5 and 6.
7 through 9, you're going to want to be making your way over to the Farm Progress Arena, checking in, please. Thank you.
ring, and at the end here I did have the top two switch animals for me. It was a very close placing at the top of the class, and ultimately what set the two apart at the top was their ability to handle the cow. So as a reminder, the front foot, the cow needs to be forward when it's closest to the judge, and so that's just what kind of set the two at the top apart. But both did a phenomenal job with their respective animals. They worked really well as a group. They moved very smoothly and had their animals looking the best at all times. Again, they were very knowledgeable about their animals and did a beautiful job fitting. So second over third, again, just her ability to always be conscientiously looking at me, knowing how to set her animal up and always having her eye on the judge. And that places her over the young lady in third. The young lady in third did a phenomenal job of, again, making her heifer look the best that it could. The heifer, again, that needed to be pinched down or had its tail head placement fixed, and she was very, very aware of that and did those things as needed. And that those reasons are why she places over a young lady with the Jersey heifer. And again, the Jersey heifer was a little bit unruly today, but when she did handle, the young lady was able to show her off very well. And so ultimately, those were the reasons why those four young exhibitors placed at the top of the class today. But great job throughout. I talked to everybody individually and had a few recommendations for everyone. So congratulations to all the exhibitors in the junior class. Congratulations to the winner of our junior showmanship class. Trophy sponsor is Butch and Farm Ridge. East Central Select Sires donated a show halter, and Compere Financial donated a championship sweatshirt to our winner. And our winner today was Zach Paulson, running a blue ribbon. Our second blue was Shannon Byers France with a blue ribbon. Placing third was Maria Stolitsky, earning a blue ribbon. Fourth was Avila Giselle, which is earning a red ribbon. In fifth place, in earning a red ribbon, was Michael Kelly. In sixth place, in earning a red ribbon, was Adeline Knott. In seventh was Abby Recker, earning a red. Earning in eighth place, and earning a white, was Trey Hildebrandt. In ninth, earning a white ribbon, was Alexandra McCarthy. In 10th, earning a white ribbon, was Owen Schoberg. And in 11th, an earning white ribbon, was Ian Spolk. Entering the ring at this time, we have our intermediate showman. And our intermediate showman are first members in grades 7 through 9.
reminder that the individuals who win each of these classes today will come back to for the Supreme Dairy Showman Honors, and that will be held immediately after a senior showmanship. So once again, we just need our first place winner in each of those classes this morning.
Thank you.
reminder, for the individuals in our intermediate and senior showmanship classes, the top four have the opportunity to participate in the Supreme Showmanship class, which is going to be held Saturday night here in the Farm Progress Arena. If you choose to participate in the Supreme Showmanship contest, you will be teamed up with members from that show swine, sheep, and beef, as well as the dairy animals. You've been put into teams of four, and you will be competing as a team on Saturday night. There are, I believe, $6,500 worth of prizes for our teams that will be competing on Saturday night. So, if you are placing the top four as an intermediate or a senior in their classes today, they're going to ask you if you are going to participate in the contest. If you are not, they need to know that as well. The teams will then, all of you will need to meet in the swine barn, in the swine showmanship ring, following showmanship at the pig barn tonight, which is going to be somewhere between about 7:30 and 8 o'clock. to thank Oprah Wells for their help in show ring cleanup this morning. At this time, we'd like to have a representative of the Mayville Lucky Clovers. So we get a representative of the Mayville Lucky Clovers. We'd appreciate that. And for a senior showman, our judge is starting to make some decisions with the intermediate class. So at this time, if you are not already in and registered for senior showmanship, I'd recommend that you make your way over here at this time. Thank you.
we have another big round of applause for these intermediate showmen. So again, another tremendous group of showmen, and I talked to everybody individually, so I won't belabor a lot of the points here in my reasons, but there's four exhibitors that really sorted themselves to the top of this class quite handily. And today, this young lady that's in first, she really was the complete package. She shows her animals the best of its abilities. She not only is very attentive to what makes her heifer look the best, but also always had an eye on the judge. And when we had switched animals there at the end, she did a really good job of making the animal that she was leading look its best. So that's what puts her over the girl in second with the cow. And again, cows are a lot of work. It can be a lot of struggle. But again, they can tell that they have done a lot of work together and trained to get to where we are today. So fantastic job. And again, it's just small things separating these four at the top, foot positioning, quickness of getting animals set up. But they really all four did a phenomenal job, taking nothing away from the other members at the lower end of the class. Everybody really did a fantastic job, and we talked about some things to do for improvement with everybody in the class. So congratulations to all the exhibitors. Congratulations to our winner of the Intermediate Showmanship, Ella Paulson. Ella won a trophy sponsored by Milking Shorthorn. She also won a show halter donated by East Central Select Fighters and a championship showman sweatshirt donated by Tom Pierre Financial. Placing second in the class was Faith Paulson, earning a blue ribbon. Placing third in earning blue ribbon was Elizabeth Gutz. Placing fourth in earning blue ribbon was Matt Hansen. In fifth, and earning a red ribbon was Tiana Hildebrandt. In sixth, we had Shelley Hildebrandt earning a red. In seventh, we have Laura Giroux earning a red. And in eighth, Ariola Hildebrandt earning a red. In ninth, it's Kelsey Ewart earning a white. Placing 10th was Nicole Recker earning a white. Placing 11th was Sawyer Titterly earning a white. We had Carly Nails placing 12th with a white. So congratulations to our exhibitors. As a reminder, Emma Paulson, Faith Paulson, Elizabeth Gunn, and Matthew Hansen each have agreed to be part of the Supreme Showmanship Contest, which will be held in here tomorrow night. Again, the top four in the intermediate and senior divisions have the opportunity to team up with exhibitors from the swine, beef, and sheep shows to compete for that Supreme Showman Contest tomorrow night. Thank you.
our major lucky clovers for their help for show ring cleanup. At this time, we'd like to ask a representative of ASCO Perseverance to please come over and help us with the show, the show ring cleanup, please. Joining us in the ring at this time is our senior showmanship class. Our senior showmanship class is made up of individuals who are grades 10 and above. Immediately following this class, we will have the winners, the first place individuals, from our previous classes this morning. Those individuals will compete for a Supreme Showmanship title. Immediately following the Supreme Showmanship competition, we'll be moving into our Junior Bridges class, which is for kids who are entering grades 3 and 4.
Thank you.
representative of the Asico Perseverance to please help with the show ring cleanup at this time? Again, we're looking for a representative of the Asico Perseverance, please. feet back in the northeast corner of the Farm Progress Arena. We're looking for those to go to weight. Get that morning snack. Thank you. I'd like to thank the Astigo Perseverance for their help in the show ring cleanup. At this time, we're looking for a representative of the Richwood Rangers. Again, we need someone from Richwood Rangers to please help in show ring cleanup.
So if you have an entry in the Junior Britches contest,
We are asking that you make your way to the Farm Progress Arena and check in, please. So bring those junior britches calves over to the Farm Progress Arena at this time and please get checked in.
senior showman. As you can see at the end of the ring here, I have picked out the top six to switch animals and go around the ring one more time. And there you can see ultimately how tough it is to show these cows and what good training these young people have done to get their animals looking well. Ultimately, it's splitting hairs between these top six showmen, in my opinion. Many of you may not agree with how I placed it today, but this is how I feel today when we switch holders and how they react with their animals, how the placing is going to be. So the lady in first place today, although her heifer, the longer we go on here, has a little bit of that Jersey attitude. She's very much persevered and shown that heifer's the best for abilities when she is cooperating. When we switch holders again, she was able to be on a heifer that was a little bit more well-behaved today. She did a fantastic job. And again, all top six really did phenomenal jobs. It's splitting hairs between things that I saw them do or not do in the ring that kind of got into their placings today. But from top to bottom of the class, you all should be very proud. Congratulations.
Again, if you are interested in participating in our junior
your britches, you don't want to leave when showmanship is over. We have our little exhibitors entering grades 3 and 4 who will be competing in junior britches contest immediately following the naming of our Supreme Showman. If you are not registered yet, please make sure you get to the call to the Farm Progress Arena and check in, please.
Thank you.
for our young members entering grades 3 and 4.